Hello and welcome to another Nexus 5 tutorial. Today we're gonna dive deeper in the secret of the Nexus 5, and it's got a lot of secrets, but we're gonna keep it simple so you can follow along. First we start the Nexus 5, already did, and already loaded the saw initial. Here you can do this. Reset to saw initial, and then it comes with the preloaded effects. And for this tutorial sake, I throw them away. And we are left over with the simple saw, which we can edit, of course. Now we go to the layout. And here you can see the engine running the saw and all the options that are coming with it. The sign, the square, the triangle, the pulse, and the noise, which is making a lot of noise. But we start with the saw. We're gonna make a very simple preset, some dense preset, and you don't not really need much for that kind of music. Actually, this could already be very good basis for a dance song, but let's spice it up a little. Here you can see the filter, of course, when you're turning it down. It's gonna do that, and then you see all the different filters. I really don't know what it all stands for, but sound funny, but a little broken. Usable, but we go to the normal, this one. We're gonna make it move with an LFO. You select this arrow thingy, and then you drag and drop it, and then you see what it does. Follow this sine wave. And of course you can make another wave. And it sounds like that. And you can speed up the process. And now it's in sync, but you can turn sync off. You can make some really nice effect with it. For example, you can drag and drop this one for the speed. It's already nice sounds, which you can use in some productions. We're gonna undo this. Undo. And and do this one also. I'm gonna look at the arpeggiator. Have to turn it on, of course. Swing setting, the swing. I lost my swing. Poly, I'm gonna make it poly. There you have it, there you have it. And you can also click them away. And then you have a very nice sound there, let me say. And you can drag and drop your own MIDI thingy. You can drag and drop your own MIDI sample. Your MIDI, not, it's not sample, it's your MIDI, help me out, MIDI block. We call it the MIDI block in a professional fuck jargon. Double click. And then we select some notes. And then we play it. And it's very bad. But for tutorial's sake, we're gonna drag and drop it. Like it's hot. As you can see, it doesn't work because I guess it's not. Input. Oh, they should have made it drag and drop. Why they did not make it drag and drop? Really, you have to export this as a MIDI file. Export MIDI loop. And then you call it this. And then you import that. But you cannot see this, so don't do that. No, don't do that. Okay. Okay, tot nu toe was this very helpful. I'm gonna show nu some andere dingen, zoals, don't know what. Andere dingen, of course. I'm gonna show you something very nice. We're gonna show you something very nice, and we're gonna click on this. Then you hear a noise. Beep, beep. You hear another noise, beep. All jokes apart, it sounds terrible. Here you can even make different layers, name, clap. And when you want to add another arpeggiator layer, now say I want another arpeggiator layer, then you can tell it's not possible. But it's possible. It should be possible. So why it's not possible? You know why it's not possible? What am I doing wrong? I'm doing something wrong. Crash. Crash. We're gonna add another layer. And we don't take a regular saw, but we select a wavetable. And it's requiring content of Nexus 4 or 5 or Christmas or ROM extensions or dark red. We go for dark red. Wow, look at the dark red. I really would say it's green, but we turn this one off. You go silent. Silent one. Sounding very dark red already. Scratch on my nose. Here we can also make this knob move with an LFO. LFO 1. You see the LFO 1. I hope you hear it by now. What it's doing? Look, it looks like a caterpillar on a black leaf. It's beautiful. I'm wondering where it's going. Think to another musical arrangement. Still sounding boring. I think it's beautiful. We're getting somewhere. We're getting somewhere. Gonna put some effects on the effect chain. The only thing I always use is a reverb. I love reverbs. And of course, a delay can never be missed. Some ping pong. Now we're gonna pump it up with some tube. Turn on the other oscillator. And there you have it. So you never have to buy a preset ever again, because you can make them yourselves. We're not even barely scratch the surface of it, and probably never gonna do that because it's so big. It's big. Thank you for watching. If you made it to here, I mean all the way 15 minutes, 40 minutes still watching this tutorial, I want to thank you. Thank you. It had to be very hard to look at, but hope you see you next time. If you really like it and you want to see more, subscribe. And if you really hate it, also subscribe. See you later. Peace.